Filmmaker and activist Sharmeen Obaid-Chinoy is the only female director to have won two Academy Awards by the age of 37. She's also the first woman and the first person of color to direct a Star Wars film.
We're in 2024 now, and I think it's about time that we had a woman come forward to shape the story in a galaxy far, far away.
In October 2022, Sharmeen Obaid-Chinoy, a filmmaker, was picked to direct an upcoming Star Wars movie. But when she made those comments on CNN on New Year's Eve, it provoked outrage among a very fragile sect of the Star Wars audience, and especially the right. Now conservatives are slamming both Obaid-Chinoy and the movie, even though it hasn't been made yet. And we'll get to that outrage in a second, because there's even more context that you need to see to understand their fervor. Take a look at this.
I like to make men uncomfortable. I enjoy making men uncomfortable. It is important to be able to look into the eyes of a man and say, I am here, and recognize that. And recognize that I am working to bring something that makes you uncomfortable, and it should make you uncomfortable, because you need to change your attitude. And it's only when you're uncomfortable, when you're shifty, when you have to have difficult conversations, that you will perhaps look at yourself in the mirror and not like the reflection, and then say, maybe there is something wrong with the way I think.
Within the context of Obaid-Chinoy's career, that those comments are not that outrageous. Obaid-Chinoy's entire career as an activist, filmmaker, and journalist has been dedicated to spotlighting gender inequality, especially in her home country of Pakistan. Those two Academy Awards she's won before age 37 were for short documentaries she made about Pakistani women facing acid attacks and honor killings at the hands of men. It's really important material. It's really heartbreaking stories. Nonetheless, the hosts of Outnumbered on Fox had a field day going after Obaid-Chinoy.
This is the reason why people are just walking away from Hollywood and just saying, I'm not gonna go see it. It will be a flop now. Men that know this and watch this are not gonna go now watch this movie and go, oh, I can't wait to go see her make me feel uncomfortable. And somehow implying that Star Wars needs to be fixed. And if we were laughing when we were watching this out there, because can you imagine if a dude said this on stage, like, I love making women feel uncomfortable as I make movies.
I'm a mother of three sons. I'll tell you, it is my sons and my husband who are always wanting to watch Star Wars. If her goal is to make men feel uncomfortable, guess what? They're not going to watch it, and I'm certainly not going to be the one to pull it up.
That's why I am a Trekkie.
Ooh,
and not Star Wars.
Okay, that was Emily Campagno at the end saying she was a Trekkie and not Star Wars. So our wonderful team here took a look at Star Trek and the subversive and in that moment very progressive relative to the regressive societal norms at the time. Stories, topics, characters that they took on in that series. Here are some of the ways that the show's creator, Gene Roddenberry, defied the regressive social norms of his time. Roddenberry put Japanese American George Takei as Lieutenant, Sulu? I've never watched Star Trek. I'm sorry, don't get mad at me.
Blasphemy.
I'm going to butcher some of these names, but the point still stands. At the helm, African American Nichelle Nichols as Lieutenant Nyota Uhura. In the communications chair, and even attempted to make the Enterprise's first officer a woman, studio executives rejected that unsavory idea, so the alien Spock took the job. In the third and final season, Uhura and Captain Kirk shared one of the first interracial kisses ever broadcast on American television. And though it wasn't the very first, Nancy Sinatra and Sammy Davis Jr. had kiss on air during a special a year earlier, it became another watershed event in television history. And in 1991, Roddenberry told the press that he planned to add an LGBT character to the Star Trek The Next Generation cast that season. But when he died suddenly a few months after the interview, his promise vaporized. So are you both planning to see the new Star Wars? Are you upset? Are you uncomfortable? how mad are you?
Well, I mean, there's a woman directing it, so by definition, it must be terrible. I mean, it doesn't exist. It doesn't exist, but I have decided that ahead of time.
Yeah, yeah, it's good.
Because I mean, how could a woman direct a movie and have it not suck? They say with a straight face. Okay, so let's break down how stupid they are in every way. So number one, when she said, oh, that's why I'm a Trekkie. I'm like, oh, okay, so you're not a Trekkie. You don't know anything about Star Trek, because Gene Roddenberry was the original Hollywood liberal. Okay, along with Norman Lear. And he, if anyone was woke, it was Gene Roddenberry. Okay, he tried in every way to bring those wonderful ideas of diversity and equality to the American culture through television. Oops, you would have hated him. Okay, so number two, they didn't find that clip of hers from 8 years ago, like ahead of time. No one knew about that clip. The minute she was picked, they hated her because she's a woman and a woman of color. They went looking for a clip. So here we go again, character assassination, right? Dig, 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 dig. Then they find this clip of her saying that she's making men uncomfortable who do acid attacks on women in Pakistan. Apparently, Fox News is okay with that. They're like, acid attacks on women, awesome! I can't believe she's making them feel uncomfortable, right? Oh, they didn't tell you that part. Why? Because they're liars, okay? They're making it seem like she's doing Star Wars, and you heard the clip. And she's doing Star Wars to make men uncomfortable. He said that.
Well, I liked when he said, imagine if a man had said that I'm making this movie to make women feel uncomfortable. Dude, it was a patriarchy. They've lived under the fist of the man. And she, as you've said, she's done films, Academy Award winning films about it. I mean, those are even more extreme than just the general patriarchy that exists. Don't you understand? That's truly, you know, punching down. That was an insane comment. The whole thing is just, it really speaks to the deep space, deliberate reference that those guys live in.
And none of those famous directors have ever made women uncomfortable.
Right.
Or the movie producers or the actors. They've never made women uncomfortable.
Just to talk about that feeling though. How do you see film? If being uncomfortable is something you immediately oppose. I think that's one of the joys of watching and enjoying film as an art. I love horror. I think that it's exciting. I know some people don't like it because of that feeling. But I think having a feeling of suspense, anxiety, given to you and provided to you through a movie is really interesting. That's a great form of art. When you're complaining about being made uncomfortable, like, do you just want like baby food and on the big screen? That seems to be what they want. They want something easily digestible. You saw it in their outrage to other Star Wars films in the most recent trilogy. When Rian Johnson, whatever you want to say about that movie, I liked it because it was different. They all got upset because it wasn't the same fan service over and over and over again. But also, there was a woman hero. Rose Tico came out of nowhere, saved the day, and they flipped out, and then she wasn't, and then she was reduced to a minor role in the next movie.
Yeah, and the other thing I don't understand about the right wing mindset is immediately judging someone based on their race, sex, etc. instantly. Like if you said to me, there's a white Christian male directing a movie, I wouldn't be like, oh, it's a good, I hate it. First of all, then I'd hate like 90% of movies. It's such a foreign concept. It's so stupid that like, and we don't think that way. We don't think like, oh, white person, we don't like it. Christian, we don't like it. Male, we don't like it. But for them, the minute they hear woman and non-white, I hate it. Oh, let's go find something dirty about her. And prejudge a movie that isn't made. I just don't understand the mindset. Get help.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.